However, it's not only bombing raids that children in the war-torn city need to be wary of. For the young suffering from illness, Western sanctions are only making matters worse. Earlier this month, a UN report strongly criticizing Western sanctions on Syria was leaked to online publication The Intercept. The sanctions in question were imposed on the country back in 2011 in an attempt to force President Assad to step down, and included trade restrictions, bans of oil export and banking, and also freezing government assets. Well, the report revealed that the sanctions mostly harmed Syrian civilians and obstructed aid workers, as the bureaucratic procedures discouraged many organizations from providing humanitarian relief to the country. Even the UN itself was having problems exporting items for basic human needs as well as vital medication. Artis Moragas-Diev spoke to some of those hit hard by the sanctions.
If you know what you're looking for, you may be able to tell. But there's something odd about these children. And there is. They all have cancer. And many of them are dying from forms of cancer that are perfectly treatable.
Just not here. Selling cancer medicine to Syria is a criminal act, thanks to European and American sanctions. Or any other life-saving drugs, too, for the matter. Or even medical equipment. And children are dying for it. They're brave, and they'll need to be. Of the roughly 200 children with cancer in Aleppo, 30 have died, and only 9 have survived the disease.
Almost all the children who've died of cancer have done so because of European sanctions. We asked the European Union and humanitarian agencies to lift the sanctions and let cancer medicine in because children are suffering.
For 4 years, Europe has ignored those pleas, and the casualties among the innocent are mounting.
This is 3-year-old Wafa. She had eye cancer. They could have treated it, but Western sanctions made getting the medicine impossible. And the only hospital that specialized in cancer in Aleppo, Kindi Hospital, was taken by rebels and destroyed in fighting. They had to amputate her eye. But she's fine now. She lived. Many other kids won't.
For a year, she lived with an empty eye socket, until this organization, Cancer Care Syria, saved enough money to buy her a new one. It changed her life.
She said, "Look at me. I have my second eye. Now nobody will stare at me strangely."
CCS doesn't get international grants or media headlines. They don't boast. They just save and enhance lives as best they can.
I like to help them. I have a lot of friends here. I love them, and they love me.
This little girl, Kamar, also has cancer, though no one tells her. She only knows that she's a little sick. Kamar thinks she comes here to help suffering children, but they too help her.
When the war began, we dreamt of opening a specialized children's cancer hospital. But we don't have that sort of money. We don't even have $6,000 a month for medicine for the children.
That's all they need to treat hundreds of children in Aleppo, and they struggle each month to collect that tiny sum. They buy and smuggle cancer medicine from Lebanon. Then there's food.
Even with medicine, the children need enough food or they won't survive. It's what all the mothers think about, having enough food for the children.
They look happy here, but bear this in mind. A year from now, some of these kids will be gone. Murad Gazdiev, RT, in Aleppo. Moscow.